So this is my study, where I spend quite a bit of my time when I'm in the UK. I moved here about 6 years ago and slowly converted this, what was a ruined farmstead, which I share with Srimala and Sona. We've each got our own separate quarters. And I came here from Madhyamaloka. I'd lived at Madhyamaloka for, I think it was 8 years, from 1996. Before that, I was at Guhyaloka, and before that, I was at Padmaloka. I was at Padmaloka for 12 years. Before that, I was at the LBC, setting up the LBC. I've been ordained now since 1973. Most of my life I've been an order member. More than half my life I've been an order member. I was born in 1947 in Chatham in Kent, and brought up mainly there, although my father was in the British Navy and spent some time in Malta, and then after he retired from the British Navy, he was in the Nigerian Navy. So I used to go out for the holidays over 5 or 6 years to Africa, which is a quite important experience for me, seeing a larger world. And I studied in London. I did a degree in philosophy at a college connected with London University. And when I graduated, I tried to think what I wanted to do. I didn't want an ordinary career. I was quite interested in social work, but not very deeply so. And about that time, I came across Sangharakshita and the nascent FWBO, as it was then, which very quickly I found myself responding to. And I was teaching in central London, and I used to go along every week. And after some time, I moved away for a little bit and lived in the countryside with an idea of doing more meditation and living a more concentrated spiritual life, which, of course, I was not capable of at that time. So I moved back to London and moved into a community. And I lived in communities for, must be the next 25, 27 years. Variety of communities. And I was ordained in 1973 in Suffolk by Bante, both my private and public preceptor. There was nobody else at that time. He did the lot. And I've done a variety of things in my time. I was the founding chairman of the LBC and presided over the building project. I went off to Greece for a few months to write a book, very pleasant experience, although also quite taxing being on one's own and trying to learn to write. And then I moved to Padmaloka, and I was Bante's secretary over, I think, a period of 12 years, no, 8 years, although I was around at Padmaloka for 12 years. Towards the end of that period, Bante asked me to take on the men's ordination process and the retreat centre at Padmaloka. And with Suvadra, Surata, Sona, Aloka, Padmavadra, Chittapala played a very, very important part in that process. We established the men's ordination process, and the broad outlines of the ethos, at least, of what we did are still functioning today. And have strongly influenced the women's process too. We worked very closely with the women setting up the process that eventually became what happens at Sri Ratnaloka. So that was a very fruitful and significant part of my life. I give lots of talks, lots of study groups. Sometimes I do two different study groups every day. I used to move my chair between the two study groups so that I remembered that I was in a different group. It really worked. And at the end of that period, I stayed in Guhyaloka for 3 years, although a lot of that time I wasn't actually there. I was in India or over here in the UK. And there I wrote a book on Sangharakshita's ideas, A New Voice in the Buddhist Tradition. Sangharakshita, A New Voice in the Buddhist Tradition. Which I think actually is one of the best things I've done, although it's not so widely known. But at the end of that period, Bhante asked me and other senior order members to gather in Birmingham at Majimaloka to establish the Preceptors' College Council and the college itself. And in 2000, he appointed me the first chair of the Preceptors' College. About 2004, I decided I wouldn't continue with that responsibility. I decided I needed to broaden out in various ways, and particularly I wanted to do more meditation and have more solitude. And through a set of completely coincidental occurrences, I ended up in this place with Srimala. She had some money, I had some money. And so we bought the place, more or less just on seeing it. We saw it and both responded very strongly to it without exactly thinking through the implications. I agreed to go into it. We had to do quite a lot of work to set it up. It's now all finished. And we've each of us our own separate house, really. I've got a couple of rooms here, a kitchen and a small bathroom, so I can be completely in solitude here. And Srimala has a house at the top of the premises of the property, which is much more spacious than mine, I'd like to point out. And Sona has recently moved in with us, and he's got his own quarters, and we've built or rather converted a barn into a small retreat centre, a retreat facility, guest facility. And from time to time we have events here, or friends just come and stay. Srimala's daughters come with her grandchildren. I partly stay out of the way, partly enjoy vicarious grandparenthood. I'm not able to spend as much time here as I'd like. Effectively, I'm probably spending 4 months a year here in two tranches because I spend 6 months in India every year in two parts, 3 months at a time, 3 months over the winter, 3 months during the monsoon, which is our summer here. So yes, I spend two periods of 2 months or so here. I also spend time in Hungary, a couple of weeks in Hungary with our mitras there who are working amongst Gypsy Roma people. It's a work I very, very much value. I don't have to do much, but I'm able to support them and bask in reflected glory from what they do. I really do very little myself. And I've also got responsibility as president of the LBC, which means I visit for 9 or 10 days twice a year. And again, I very much appreciate that work. Particularly fortunate because I had to work quite hard with Atula and a number of others to set that place up. It's quite a struggle, although for me at least a very rewarding one. Others have more mixed feelings because it was quite tough. I don't mind tough. Or I didn't mind tough, I was young then. But, you know, I'm able to see, you know, 30 years down the line, people benefiting very, very much from the work that we did. And a whole new generation, none of whom can remember those days, who are introduced to the Dhamma through the LBC. My job as a president is simply to make sure that things are online, in the sense, the old-fashioned sense of being on the right lines. And I give talks and so forth there. Apart from that, I'm a member of the Preceptors College, so I need to go to those meetings. And I undertake some other activities when I'm invited, although unfortunately I'm not able to accept as much as I'd like to, because I need to be here much more to do more writing. Over the last 2 years, I've mainly concentrated on interviews I've done with Bante, in which I've been clarifying various issues with him that I believe to be very important, and that clearly he does too. I did interviews with him, which published, of course, on his website and elsewhere, and then I've done other interviews which I've written up in my own words, and I've got a couple more to do. I've got one on the ordination ceremony, which is what I hope to get on with these coming weeks. And then next year I want to write up some interviews I did with him on the subject of the new society, just bringing that whole notion up to date. I love this place. I very much appreciate what it does for me. In 2008, I was here without going out, without getting in a car, for 8 months. And for 5 months, I was completely alone. I didn't see anybody. I didn't talk to anybody. And from here, you don't see anybody at all. Occasionally, the farmer comes around to see the sheep. I see a lot of sheep, of course. They never got used to me. I see a lot of birds. An otter occasionally comes down our river, a little stream rather. River would be heavily over-dignifying it. Yes, and a lot of weasels and bank voles, little rodents of various kinds. I'm particularly fond of the weasels. Occasional rat, of course. So it's a lovely place to be on solitary, even though the weather was probably the most miserable on record. I think we had one sunny day in those 8 months. And I must say at times that rather mirrored the inner weather, but I very much appreciated the solitude, the silence, and it's quite an important period for me spiritually. So I come back to dip back into that experience of complete openness. I also appreciate this place because it is in the heart of the Welsh land, and all my neighbours are Welsh speaking, and I'm very aware of the atmosphere of Wales, the ancient atmosphere of Wales. And feel that this is a place where nature is still very much alive, and that perhaps even other forces are present in the mountains and the sky. And although I'm not one who sees things in that way, I sort of feel a definite presence of a more raw, more natural world. So that's quite important to me, being here. And it's a very good base for going off to India, going off to London, going off to Hungary. A very good place to come back to.